playing lots of different pieces on our concerts. Our next two pieces are a real treat. We're so thrilled to have two guest artists with us tonight, playing the absolutely wonderful Schindler's List, and then a wonderful Spanish dance called Bailes para Orquesta. And it's four dances, and it has everything from these nice, intense fiesta sort of motives, and then what could be called a whimsical salsa in the middle. We are very honored and privileged to have two guest artists with us tonight. I'm going to have them come on stage in a minute. They are John Schultz, who is a great friend of the program. He actually has some links to Muscatine. He had a former student by the name of Giles Joslin. And Giles was very important to the orchestra program and founded our String Fest concert. So he has that great connection to our community. And he has been incredibly inspiring to our kids. And then Albert Wakalis is a violist from the Philippines. And he flew out just for this gig. I'm just kidding. Actually, he lives in Macomb. And he's a grad student at Western Illinois University. And he's actually been coming in and working with our high string players every week on technique, everything from intonation to life lessons. And the kids have come to adore both of them. So it is my privilege to welcome to the stage Mr. John Schultz and Mr. Albert Wakalis. And I asked John he was telling the orchestra a little story about that he would like to share with the, pardon me, I'm misspeaking, he wanted to share it with the kids, and then I asked, would you please share it with the audience? So I want him to talk a little bit about his good memories of this particular piece, and I'll just give it to you.
Well, good evening, everybody. It's a real pleasure to be here, and it's been just a great pleasure to make music, not only with Mr. Thelman and the orchestra, but Albert. And, to share a piece that's so special and so profoundly important is a great opportunity. It's one of my most beloved pieces. And, you know, there are always stories in music. There are stories and connections, as Mr. Thoma alluded to. You know, I have a connection here to Muscatine through my student, Giles. And this violin has a connection at some level to the piece we're going to play. That's a story I want to share with you. So, you know, violins hopefully last a lot longer than the owners. They last hopefully many generations. This one is 154 years old. And since the first 141 years of his existence, I don't know where it was, but I know now that E. Scott Bryce owned the violin previous to me. And he was a gentleman that lived in St. Cloud, Minnesota. And in addition to being a humanities professor at St. Cloud University, he helped found a number of amateur orchestras and was an amateur violinist himself. Now, when I acquired the violin, his daughter said that all of that was important to him, but one of the most important parts of his life is that him and his wife Lynn helped bring countless, well over 100 Holocaust survivors to the United States after the atrocities of the Holocaust. And so he helped them get settled and find work and find homes here in the United States. So with that, it's a great pleasure to share this piece on this violin with all of you today, and I'd like to dedicate the poem to this E. Scott Bryce and his wife Lynn for the incredible work they did.
Yeah.
for something totally different.
Oh, I'm sorry.